Bonjour, my friends. I hope you're having a wonderful Thursday. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create your own custom Canva frames. These will have multiple layers which will allow you to add depth and dimension to your designs. So without further ado, let's get into it. To start, we're gonna need an image that will serve as a base to help us draw the frames. For demonstration purposes, I got this coffee cup image from unsplash.com. Since we're gonna need to export this project as a PDF file later, we need to create a page first. To do this, pick the artboard tool from the toolbar and draw around the edges of the image. If you open the layers panel, you will find that the image is put inside a folder called Artboard 1. Double click on it and rename it to Page 1. Next, we're gonna create shapes of all the parts of the object that we would like to create frames for. I'm gonna be using the pen tool for this purpose. If you're not familiar with the pen tool, I've linked some tutorials in the description below if you'd like to learn how to use it. If you need to change the shape fill color, open the Layers tab and double-click the shape layer, then pick your favorite color. Next, go ahead and hide the shape layer, activate the background layer, and pick the pen tool to create the next frame. Do the same for all the other parts of the object for which you would like to create frames for. In my case, the cup has three parts, therefore I'm going to create three shape layers and sample a close color for each one from the background image. Once finished, convert each shape layer to a smart object. And put each one inside a separate group by pressing Command plus G on Mac or Control plus G on Windows. Double click the folder and pick a number like 1, 2, 3, etc. Do the same for all the shapes that you have. Next, Command or Control click the thumbnail of each layer to make a selection of it. Go to the Paths panel and click the icon at the bottom that says Selection to Path. Go back to the Layers tab and make sure that the folder is highlighted. Then go to Layer, Vector Mask, Current Path. You will notice that a mask is applied on the folder. Follow the same steps for the other folders as well. Now, since we no longer need that background image, you can go ahead and hide or delete it. Last but not least, go to File, Export, PDF, and click Save. Now for the fun part. Head over to canva.com and create a blank document. On the left hand of the screen, click on Uploads, then Upload Files. Find and open the PDF file created earlier. Now, when you hover over the objects, you will see that each part is above or below the other. Therefore, you can fill each one with a different image or pattern, however you like. That is it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. If you got questions, leave a comment below and make sure to stick around for more videos like this coming soon. Catch you in the next one. Peace.